Hello guys, good morning everyone. Today's topic is slightly different from what we talked earlier, that is design of pressure vessel. We all know that there are several cylinders and tanks could be widely seen everywhere at most of the work areas such as petrochemical plants, refineries, or can also be used as storage tanks. Even at for domestic applications also, we could say that LPG cylinder or CNG cylinder can also be served as the application for pressure vessel. But when we talk that how pressure vessel looks like, or what could be the specific application of pressure vessel, or how could they look alike, then we can say that it's a storage tank or a cylinder where you are actually storing some fluids under some stipulated temperature. Now the application for pressure vessel could be domestic or industrial, where you are actually using. And we also know that we have to store anything inside the pressure vessel up till some state of pressure, and the pressure has to be maintained up till some limit, so that whatever material selection for the manufacturing of pressure vessel takes place, that overall criteria is dependent on the inside or the internal pressure. And when we are designing the pressure vessel, we have to take utmost care so that the rupture or the failure of pressure vessel could lead to the loss of life in the property. And we have to make it sure that who are the users and who are they are using, at what place and at what conditions they are using, we have to make it sure that the pressure vessels are safe enough. When we talk about the applications, or when we talk about where they are used, for example, chambers or recompression chambers, distillation towers, mining operations, petrochemical plants, submarines, space shuttle or spaceship habitats, storage vessels, and some of the storage vessels can be used for storing gases like ammonia, chlorine, propane, etc. As I said earlier, pressure vessels are widely used and used as per the application where you are going to categorize. It could be industrial or it could be domestic. And the classification, that means the how the types of pressure vessel could be used and how they are categorized, and categorized on the basis of what criteria. So sorry, there is some slight change in the sequence of the slides, so I'll be directly going to the classification of pressure vessel. So when we talk that how the classifications are done for pressure vessel, one is according to the dimensions, another one is according to the end constructions. Dimension means the main important dimension for the pressure vessel, that is the thickness, which can also be said as the wall thickness of the pressure vessel. And that classification is again categorized into the thick cylinder pressure vessel and thin cylinder pressure vessel. Now both are having different definitions or different meanings because both are serving different applications. Next is according to the end constructions. End constructions means that how you are closing the ends, because pressure vessels are made in such a way that you are actually rolling the sheet metal and you are going out from some riveting or welding process for the joining operations. But what about the ends, the two ends that could be open or that could be closed? So that was the basic classification of pressure vessel, that how a pressure vessel can be categorized or classified according to the dimensions and end constructions. Now we'll go for the standards and codes. Why we need standards? Because we need standards for defining some policies or some procedural steps that how you could construct a pressure vessel, where you are going to use the pressure vessel, what could be the safety precautions could be used for the pressure vessel, how the effectiveness or the efficiency of the pressure vessel can be improved, how the cost of construction of the pressure vessel can be maintained or can be reduced, how these pressure vessels could be different from other pressure vessels, and how you will categorize or how you will nominate the operators for construction of pressure vessel. So all these policies, sections, rules, regulations are defined by some standard organizations or authorities throughout the world. So these are the basic, what I say, that standards available in the world. As you can see, ASME BPVC section 8, this is the most widely used code for the construction of pressure vessel. Now it is showing boiler and pressure vessel code section 8 that defines rules for construction of pressure vessels. That means it defines and gives the proper guidelines for how you will be going through the construction of pressure vessel. That means if you want to construct a pressure vessel and your company standard is following ASME, they have to follow some certain rules and guidelines for the manufacturing or construction of pressure vessel. Same as BS 5500, former British standard for the design and construction of export equipment. Now we don't know which company follows which standard, because all over the world, depending upon the application and depending on the availability, companies follow some specific standards, such as BS is for British standard, ASME, that is American Society for Mechanical Engineers. Likewise, B5109, that shows for Canadian standard for Canadian boiler, pressure vessel and pressure piping code. Then AD Merkblätter, that is German standard, harmonized with the pressure equipment directory. European EN286 parts 1 to 4, that is European standard. That means they, European nations, those who are coming under the European nations, and they have to follow, and the companies which are following European nation standards, they have to follow some parts of the guidelines. Likewise, ISO, IAA, AIAA, these are the standards for some specific and sophisticated systems like pressurized components or pressurized structures that we see at ISS, International Space Station, that is developed by several other countries, and how they are actually using the pressurized systems and how these pressurized components can be maintained after some amount of time. So these are the some list of standards and codes of pressure vessel that are available in the market throughout the world. So this was the basic idea, what is pressure vessel, how the categories of pressure vessel is done, and how the pressure vessel can be manufactured under different standards and codes. Thank you very much.